chef with my friend. Hey, I'm doing a video for Paul McCartney. Until they see it and then they think it sucks, and it's a shame. No, hopefully it's gonna not suck. It's gonna be good.
Working with Michel is a dream come true, really. I've admired his work for years, and I didn't really realize that he's directed most of my favorite music videos.
I consider Michel as the natural son of Georges Méliès and Jean Vigo, you know, I think so. That's my opinion.
He's still like a kid, you know? And when we become adults, we lose this imaginary world where everything can be possible, and he didn't lose it.
He's he has a very fresh mind. He loves the improvisation. Even he's preparing a lot of his films, but at the last minute he can change.
It's always a little bit scary because I don't... It's a lot of elements that are a little disparate, like the music and the one style. The look of the video, hopefully it's gonna match, but till we try it, on him, on the other character, all together, hopefully it's gonna be a good match.
It's always surprising to shoot with Michel, you know?
Afternoon, this one's for you. It's an unwieldy one, so I'll bring it in, put it on the table.
I play the postman, simply the postman, who delivers a box to Sir Paul McCartney, which turns out to be the mandolin which sparks the whole scenario.
Okay, so basically the idea is that we create a house where Paul lives, and he's been delivered a sort of a box where there is a mandolin inside on the... From this box, a ghost, played by Natalie Portman, comes out. You can do anything
you wanna do. It's amazing to act alongside Natalie, although there's always a glass screen between us. We weren't actually allowed to breathe the same air. But it was great to see her, even if through a window.
We use this technique of just a transparent glass. And we have each room has a negative room, which doesn't reflect in the glass. But everybody that walks in behind the glass is gonna reflect. For instance, if you look at this seat there, and I'm sitting here, you can see me sitting in a chair there. Only it's been moved. Yeah, now I'm sitting in a chair. It's like a double exposure, but perfectly matching.
I feel pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty, so pretty and gay. You know, when I am angry with someone,
yeah.
I become white.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm trembling a little, and I'm... My voice is going lower.
Oh, yeah.
And at this moment, it's very, but it's so rare, you know.
But we'll make sure that doesn't happen.
But when I'm becoming red and I say, no, it's okay.
Because we care. Because we care about what we're doing. What we do is we do it for a living.
No, it's a difference. You are Anglo-Saxon, I am Latin.
People tolerate, don't we? It's based on pity. They end up liking him because they make so much effort to not hate him.
Michel Gondry has a big nose.
He's called teint rouge, means red skin. And I bet he told you I have a big nose, but it's okay, it's just jealous.
Michel Gondry a un gros nez, Michel Gondry a un gros nez, Michel Gondry a un gros nez, Michel Gondry a un gros nez. Une rafale de grenouille lui arracha la peau des couilles. Ah oui, vraiment, Michel Gondry a un gros nez.
He's gaining 3 years every year. So physically he looks like he's 120 years.
Salut Michel, voilà, je suis ton élève. Voilà, j'ai trouvé aussi un petit effet spécial sans utiliser les ordinateurs à la con. Voilà, comme tu vois bien ici, ça, c'est le feu. Je dois jouer le feu. Il y a lumière déjà. Et j'ai inventé encore un truc. Tu vas aimer. J'espère que tu vas aimer. C'est très facile. Regarde. Alors Michel, comment il se trouve ça? Pas mal, hein? Et merci Michel, hein?
My favorite drink. Either, if I want to be a little foo-foo, it'll be a mint julep. Yes, I said foo-foo.
There's a mint julep.
Well, see, you kids over here in the UK.
I've had one. It's a delicious cocktail. It's like a mint.
It's mint and bourbon.
Oh, bourbon. Yeah. Right.
And then, other than that, yeah, something on the whiskey variety.
Oh, whiskey gets you pissed.
It's so fun. I mean, it's not very difficult work for me. I get to just sort of prance around in a pretty dress and listen to nice music.
We have arranged a battle of the drums.
I suddenly found myself behind the bar. Tapping along with a pair of cocktail sticks.
The Gondry Club.
Felt like history in the making.
Well, so that's the end of this video. Everything went smoothly.
It was great. Good laugh.
So I think it's important to breed.
Huh?
To procreate.
Absolutely, yeah. No, my friends who don't have children, I don't know what they have to live for, or what they will have to live for in the future, you know, when we get old.
Yeah, I really agree with that.